fretboard.com. So you're having trouble with understanding your guitar fretboard and you've come to this video for help. And that's exactly what we're going to do, because having a clear understanding of the guitar neck and the way that the notes sit along and across it, along with how they repeat through other positions and how notes really work when you're building scales and constructing chords, well, that's a serious issue, both from a learning standpoint for guitar students, and it's also a serious issue when it comes down to how proficient you are at making music on this instrument. Now, if you are confused and if you're stressed out because you find the guitar fingerboard is complicated, then you're in luck, because there is a solution. And it all begins with realizing that every guitar player goes through a period where the neck does seem rather confusing, but what we're going to fix that with is we're going to introduce something to you called the 5-fret method. Now, the 5-fret method is something that was taught to me by one of my first teachers, and it has to do with how notes of the same pitch always follow a set and standardized method all along the whole span of the entire fingerboard, using locations based upon the name of the note that you're plotting through the fingerboard regions. Now, let me show you exactly how this would work if we were to do this with the note of C. All right, so let's run through how this works. First of all, I just want you to become aware of these different C note locations. We're going to start here on the first fret of second string. That's a C. The same C is up here on the third string, fifth fret. And then the same C again is on the fourth string, 10th fret. And then finally, 15th fret, fifth string, for that same C located again up there. Now, what I need you to understand is the gap between those. So if I'm on 15th fret of fifth string, and I go to this other C that's at the fourth string, 10th fret, that's a distance of 5 frets. And then if I go from this 10th fret, fourth string C to a third string, fifth fret C, again, 5 frets. However, you got to keep in mind that because of the tuning difference we have between the third and the second strings, when we go from this C from the third string to this C on the second string, it's only 4 frets. So keep that in mind, because that's important too. Coming up next, I'm going to teach you how to expand on this by using a different note and plotting it across the fretboard. Plus, I'll expand on the whole idea by showing you how to do this with chords. But before we head into all that stuff, I want to tell you about a promotional offer that's related to some of my most popular lesson plans that I've used with hundreds of guitar players right here in the studio. It's my Handouts Collection ebook. I want to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook, Volume 6. This is my latest collection of study material. There are 76 pages of great information in here, and if you already are one of the thousands of guitar players who've received your copy, you know how great this collection is. Handout Collection Volume 6 is a 76-page digital ebook that you can download and print on demand at home. We'll email you the file within 24 hours of making your donation or a Teespring merchandise purchase. Volume 6 covers the open position and bar chords. There's an arpeggio workout, a harmonized keys workout, exercises on popular triads, a lesson on how to practice scales, and all the popular modes, including Ionian, Aeolian, Dorian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. There's even a section on the diminished scale, and even some jazz theory, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper that exists. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5, or if you make a purchase from the Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support my lessons. Or you can check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. To help you fully appreciate how this method operates all over the entire fingerboard, we're going to take one more note. It's going to be an F, and we're going to establish its location all along the fretboard as well. That way you'll have a chance to completely understand exactly how this method works. We'll have done it with C, we'll have done it with F, and you'll be able to head over to the next stage of this method. So let's check in and see how an F note moves along the fretboard. Let's do this work again, but now we're going to be using F. So first of all, the location, starting from this high F on first string, first fret, to this F here on the second string, sixth fret. And then keep in mind that that's 5 frets, right? From fret 1 to fret 6, you add 5 and you got that note there. So keep that in mind. Now, of course, because we're on second string going to third string, remember, because of the tuning difference, we've only got 4 frets. So we're going from the second string, sixth fret, F, to the third string, 10th fret, F. And then finally, to wrap things up down the fretboard here from this 10th fret F on the 3rd string, our other F is located up here on the 15th fret of the 4th string. So again, 10 plus 5 gives me 15. So the understanding that you have to have with this is that the guitar really is only 5 frets long. And the thing to keep in mind, though, is whenever you're doing a movement strategy that's based off of the 3rd string going to the 2nd string, that's going to give you a distance of just 4 frets. And that's because of the tuning setup of the guitar. Our guitar is tuned in 4th intervals, except between the 3rd string to the 2nd string, it's tuned in a major 3rd. So keep that in mind. This is how you plot the neck very quickly and very easily. If you do this every day for around a month, you'll totally get used to this idea, and it'll happen for you quite fast. The next stage of applying this method involves plotting out more than one note, and that means we're going to step things up to the world of chords. Now, the first part of doing chord patterns involves just starting with a simple two-note chord shape, or what we often call in music theory, a interval. Now, these are also known to guitar players as double stops. Let's do a couple across the neck so you fully understand how this works. All right, so let's study intervals now. We're gonna begin with an A into a C sharp. And we're going to make that organized across the neck. So an A to a C sharp on the 3rd to 2nd strings is some things we want to keep in mind right away. The upper note is where we're going to start from. So if we take that 2nd fret C sharp, and remember now in this case we're going from a 2nd string to 3rd string, so that's going to need 4 frets, because whenever we go between 3rd and 2nd string we have to travel only 4 frets. So it's like we're just doing some basic math. 2 plus 4 equals 6. So go to the next string, 3rd string, and you're on the 6th fret with that same note. It's, like I said, just basic math. If we go to the next string, that A note that's located on the 2nd fret, 3rd string. Now, here we're going from 3rd string to 4th string, so we're going to do 5 frets. So 2 plus 5 is 7. 7th fret, 4th string, there's our A. So now we've got A and C sharp on the 7th and 6th frets. And from here on out, we're just doing 5 frets higher. So 6 plus 5 is 11. And then when we go to the 4th string, 7 plus 5 is 12. So 12 and 11 are the same notes, the A and C sharp, as the 7th and 6th frets of the 4th and 3rd strings. Now, from this 12 and 11, we're going pretty high now. So if you have an electric guitar, it's not too bad. But if you have an acoustic, it's going to be pretty high up there. You may not be able to do it. So, but if we do it anyway, we're going to have 4th string 11th fret plus 5, which is going to be going to the 16th fret of the 5th string. And then the 12th fret of the 5th string, up 5, takes us to 17. So 17 and 16 of the A and C sharp is equal to 12 and 11 of the A and C sharp on the next two strings over. So that's the system. It's, like I said, just basic math, and you're just kind of cascading along the fingerboard. Now, I have another quick one I want to run through with you, and it's just going to be D and F sharp. And I'll do it quickly because now you understand the method. So the first note that we have up on the 2nd fret of the 1st string of that D and F sharp, we're going to be taking F sharp up to 2nd string from 1st string, so that's 5 notes. So 2 plus 5 is 7. But when we do the 3rd fret D on the 2nd string, we're going to a 3rd string from there, so we have to only go 4. So 3 plus 4 is 7 again. So we have D and F sharp on the 7th frets of both 3rd and 2nd string, and then over here it's 3rd and 2nd fret for the 2nd and 1st strings for D and F sharp. Now, again, because we're going from an upper note here of 7th fret 2nd string, and we're going to be traveling to a 3rd string, it's only 4 notes higher. So 7 plus 4 is 11. And then if we go to the 3rd string, 7 plus 5 now, because we're going from 3rd string to 4th string, so 7 plus 5 is 12. So 12 and 11, D and F sharp is equal to 7th frets across from the 3rd string to 2nd string. You can hear they're identical. Now, if you do have an electric guitar and you want to go one further, what you can do is just add on 5 notes as you move over from the 4th and 3rd strings to the 5th and 4th strings. So 11 plus 5 is 16, and then 12 plus 5 is 17. So 17 and 16 of the 5th and 4th strings are equal to 12 and 11 of the fourth and third strings, and that completes everything with D and F sharp. And again, if you just did this every day for maybe about a month, you'd completely get hooked into how this operates. It's really great work, and it gets you to know your fingerboard like the back of your hand. You know, building a good understanding for notes on the neck and how each note relates musically to scales and chords is going to take time, and it'll take effort and practice too. But the critical element that'll make all the difference in the world to you as a musician has to do with expanding on every idea that you study like this. And this 5-fret note method is really no different. That's why if you're one of my Patreon supporters with a $15 a month pledge, you're going to get a bonus video on this subject that'll help you to start moving into larger triad chords across the fretboard with this method. Plus, we're also going to get into how this method can be used for relocating chord progressions to other places of the neck as well. And all of that will be based entirely upon this 5-fret method. So guys, along with the bonus Patreon video, you'll also get a detailed PDF handout of all this stuff that I covered in the lesson, and you'll also get a jam track. So head down to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month member today. It's at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And remember, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and thumbs up below. Also remember too, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos. It's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.